Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Kocher. Something caught my eye this week. It's a report out by the New Hampshire Fiscal Policy Institute. As a surge in business tax revenues to the state of New Hampshire, a surge. And I thought to myself, well, that means there's an economic growth surge, right? No, but we're doing well economically, but that's not the reason. There's another reason, and my guests will explain it in just a minute. But first, let me go show you the surge, and here it is. Look at that big green bar on the left-hand side. That is business profits and enterprise taxes total, and that's a 34% rise above the projections by the legislature. There it is. That shows you the surge. That's unusual. Usually you can see a little blip on one side of the line or another decrease on the other side of the line, but nothing like that. So to talk about that is my guest, who is Phil Sletten, who is the policy analyst with the New Hampshire Fiscal Policy Institute in Concord. Welcome.
Thank you very much for having me.
Nice to have you here. Nice to have you here. What is that surge, just in a nutshell?
Right, so it is a pretty large percentage increase, and we saw a large percentage increase in the last fiscal year as well, about 23%, so we're 13% on top of that. That started sharply following the passage at the federal level of the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act, the federal tax overhaul.
Federal tax code overhaul.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So that's changed a lot of the corporate tax code at the federal level,
yep.
And that likely had a pretty big impact on how a lot of businesses in our business tax base, in the state of New Hampshire's business tax
base. So that's
the culprit. Behaved.
That's the culprit. Explain it to our viewers why that's important to New Hampshire right now.
Right. So this is important to consider whether this is one-time revenue, whether this is ongoing revenue.
Right.
These are two important revenue sources, the two business taxes for the state of New Hampshire. The business profits tax is our largest tax revenue
yep.
source. And understanding how much of this revenue is one-time, it's projected that this fiscal year, maybe over $100 million of this revenue is
yep.
one-time. And how much is ongoing? How much is it because of a change in the economy or a change in the corporate tax
right.
base in a more permanent fashion?
Let's go to the next graphic, which is the 2016 business profits tax filers by type. This shows you the type of businesses that pay these taxes. And just look at the different colors. The red, the orange. The red is fiduciaries, the orange partnerships, and the gold is multinationals, and the lime green is proprietors, and the green corporations. Now let's go to the business profits tax filers by liability. And this, look at the big orange, yellow, gold, whatever it is, the big 57% item, which are the multinationals. And Phil, that is one of the big reasons for that surge.
Absolutely. So the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act at the federal level changed the incentives around keeping dollars overseas,
yep.
keeping dollars that corporations have as part of their assets overseas, and gave more incentive for those dollars to be brought back to the United States.
To be repatriated,
absolutely.
Repatriated, okay.
So that repatriation, to the extent it actually happened, is part of our business profits tax base as
yep.
the state of New Hampshire.
It has gone up.
Yes, and
okay.
that absolutely has gone up. And these data suggest that could explain a lot of that revenue spike, and probably does explain a lot of that revenue spike that we've seen recently.
But of course, the businesses out there want to know what their tax rates are. So let's look at the business profits tax rates. And here they are going back to 2015, all the way up to 2020, next year. And look at the 2019-2020 on the right side, 7.7% each year. Is that going to stay that way?
So that's a good question. The legislature is considering that now. As it is currently in law, the tax rate is scheduled to go down to 7.5% for
yep.
2021 and is scheduled to go down to 0.5% for the business business enterprise tax
yep.
In 2021 as well. That's being debated now. The House budget kept those rates at the 2018 levels, and the Senate is still debating their budget.
Okay.
So they all have to agree by the end of it.
And let's go to that business enterprise tax rate, and there it is right there. You just mentioned it, and you can see 2015 on the left, 2020 on the right, and it says 0.600, but you said it's going to go probably to
0.5 by the time you get to 2021.
Okay.
Under current law, again, this is up for debate in the legislature as we speak, and the legislature is looking to fund certain key priorities. One of the things that we analyzed at the New Hampshire Fiscal Policy Institute was looking at what some of the effects were, and what some of the effects may have been of these business tax rate reductions in recent years. And it's clear that legislators shouldn't rely on business tax rate reductions to bring in more revenue. That doesn't appear to have been the effect. So legislators legislators then have to consider, policymakers in the state have to consider, if they want to, for example, add a significant more money to local public education or to the healthcare workforce, then lower business tax rates may not bring in more money for them.
It would they shouldn't depend on the surge.
And they shouldn't depend on the surge happening again because it was likely the one-time effect of that federal tax overhaul.
Phil Sletten, policy analyst at New Hampshire Fiscal Policy Institute, thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity.